Okay, so I'm gonna work on this dog a little bit more. And I did use my little four blade, my four guard, I mean, to do his leg back here. And I'm cutting around his behind kind of short because I don't want it to, you know, we just want to keep it short back there. Because that hair grows so fast. I'm gonna do it like this, and I'm turning around and around, and yeah, I don't know why I'm just going ahead and doing the whole leg with the four guard. And I'm doing this on the reverse, so I'm getting a little bit shorter, which is not gonna hurt anything at all. You know, if you're your job, you do what you want to do, and how, you know, and what works for one might not work for another. And it just depends what all your customers want and their needs and stuff like that. That's like this little baby here, you know, I think I'm the only one that's really ever groomed him. Well, lately, I mean, I don't know about way before, but, and, so when I do, I just cut him short, and then, you know, and then it'll last quite a while, and then she'll come back, you know, and want me to do it again. So it's not like, you know, where she can come every week or every few weeks or whatever. So we just do what's most convenient for the pet and for the parents too. In, you know, moderation, whatever, you know. So. Okay. So we're going to get the hair between these little toes on this little paw. Hope you can see a little bit better what I'm doing here. He keeps speaking that. Hey, baby, we're going to get you a wrong pair of scissors. And I'll perfect it in a minute once I bathe you. I'm going to set your toe up here. Let me come back. Hold on.
Get back.
Okay. We're going to do a little toenail here. Ooh, there goes the toenail flying everywhere. Okay, come see love. Oh, it's okay. I did not hurt you at all. No, I'm making sure. You know, you're not going to be perfect every time. You know, I will confess, I have nipped, cut a little quick. But, you know, you live and learn, you know. And don't beat yourself up over it. Just be more careful the next time. Stuff happens, you know. I had felt bad one time about doing a nicking something on a puppy, and it was a lady that she was actually a hairdresser. And I was telling her, I'm sorry. And she said, girl, don't even worry about it. She said, I've cut men's ears before, you know, sniffed it. So from then on, I'm like, okay, well, if she cuts a human, sniffs a little ear sometimes, then I don't feel so bad. So anyway, I'm just going over this with this little short, with the four blades. Four guard. Why is it saying blade? I don't know. But, okay, I'm gonna, now we're gonna do your front little paw. It's so cute. But ain't that just so sweet? He is the sweetest. Wish I could keep his paw looking just like that. That is not feasible for us. This will grow out so fast. Hair between the toes. Sometimes I'll use my clippers on this, sometimes I use my scissors. This depends on what I feel like doing that day. Today I'm using the scissors. Come see though. You gotta be very careful not to sniff them. Come here. Come on. You're okay. I'm not hurting. He just does not want me mess on his feet. At all. No lie. Well, let's say his front paw, anyway. Boy, yeah, you do. We're gonna get them things taken care of right now. Okay, we're gonna cut his little nails. And when I cut their nails, half the time I don't have all this stuff on the table. Okay, come see. It's okay. Okay. I do like slivers. Oops. Little booty slid there. It's okay, Gordon. Oh, no. Okay. Like, no, I don't want my toenails cut. Well, you have to have them cut, sweetie. You don't have a choice. No, you don't. You got to get them trimmed up. We're almost done. Okay. Let me see one more time. Let me just look. Remember how your mom used to say, let me just look at it. And then they grab something, they snip it or pull something or whatever. Oh yeah. We've all been tricked by our mamas a lot to kind of work. Okay, now that wasn't so bad. I'm gonna take my clipper here and do this little number on it. angle right there, and I think I got it out. Good deal. Okay, do that. Turn around and look underneath your other little foot. Let me go ahead. Oh, you got your little good claw. Yep, I knew you had one. Yep, I knew you had one. We're just trying to get your mind off of it a little bit, huh? That's all we were doing, huh? Yeah, that's all we were doing, huh? Yep. And usually the dew claws are, you know, really easy to do. So there you go. Okay, now we're going to do this one. And I'm just going to dive right into this one. I'm not even, because I already brushed it out a while ago. And it is already soft, and it's already detangled, I guess you want to call it. Oh, and just let me say something real quick while I'm thinking about it. If your dog needs a rabies shot or any kind of shot at all, or anything done, shots, tips, Lord, I don't know what all else. Heartworm pill. Let's see, what else? A dewormer. Probably whatever you need. They at Tractor Supply on Saturdays, they go on different days, on different Saturdays. You'll have to call the one that you live closest to find out what day they're going to be there. But you can bring your pet there, and you can get we got our golden doodle he got his rabies shot there, and he got chip. It was only $37 for the chip. He gets his heartworm pill there every month, and his regular worming pill. I think they can do something all in one, so I think next time I go, I'm going to find out about that. But, and then the next time they're there, I'm going to go and talk to them, because I want to see about getting him fixed. And I don't know if they, which I know they don't do it there, but maybe they could guide me on, you know, how to get him neutered or whatever. I mean, I think I could do it, but I don't think he would like it. Just saying. But anyway, we won't tell him that I said that. So anyway, that's what so that's what I want to say. So if you can't afford to bring your dog to the vet for shots, and also they actually just sell the shots at the feed store. You can go in there. In fact, that's what I did is, but I could have brought, but they could have gave them to him on the day that the vet was there, but I was in there and thinking about it, so I went on ahead and just bought the shot, his second set, at Tractor Supply. It was $13, I think, something like that. I just came home and mixed it up and gave it to him myself. So, but you know, but they don't have like the rabies or the heartworm. You have to go for those on the day that the vet is going to be there. But anyway, that's just a little tip there for today. You know, so you can get your pet done at an affordable price, but they are really good about doing that. So, and they go regularly, so, you know, you can pick whatever Saturday you need to go and go do it, so. But anyhow, I got all his nails done, so that's a good thing. Let's pick underneath this no more. I don't like having all my tools up here on the table. I guess I'm just doing it today for some reason. I don't know why. Just one of them days. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and I'm going to go over his leg a little bit more. I don't know why I just don't go and bathe it. That's what I'm going to do. I'll just finish that later. I'm going to do a two guard. Because this right here on the side, I did do a little bit. I kind of want to blend it where this doesn't look so poofy. And being that I used a one guard on the top, I'm using a two guard right here. Just to kind of blend it a little bit better where it looks a little bit nicer. And just kind of blend it all together. Yeah, see how good that looks? Yeah, that looks a lot better. I'm kind of doing a little bit on his side, into his leg. Even though I did use the four guards on his leg, it makes it look so much better. So you don't have this big gap of it looking off or whatever. And I'm not pressing real hard against the skin. I'm just kind of like going over the top of it. To do this. So anyway, that's what I'm doing. Anyhow, that's what we're doing today. Connie's pet grooming today. A little bit of some little hairs I see while he's just standing here so still. I guess I spoke a little too soon. And I am going to go over his back a little bit more. A little bit more here. You know, that's why you have to go over the hair several times. You can't just go over it one time. You need to go over it several times. I mean, I wouldn't spend hours, but, you know, because you're not going to get every little nitpick of hair. But, you know, you need to break your hand. And then after he's clean, you will really see the difference in the hair, the way it looks. What we're going to attempt to do right now. side, and I'm going to pick up the front. Okay, yeah, I got to do a little bit underneath your arms. You want to make sure that you get under the armpits. Oh, and you also want to check your blade often, because this gets hot. Like, this is hot to the touch. Now, it wasn't hot on him with the guard on, because this covers it up. So this is not touching his skin. Just this is, but this doesn't get hot. So you want to make sure that you change your blade often. That's why I like these interchangeable blades from Andis. And I actually have a little mini refrigerator here that I got. That I got it at a garage sale. Actually, the girl gave it to me. And what I do is, as I'm grooming, I put my blades in there, because it pulls them down quicker. But you want to, on this, you want to make sure you lift up his arm and you scoop underneath his little armpit. Because, oh my goodness, they get knotted up right there bad. That's one of my little pet peeves, is underneath the little armpit. And then I just kind of get all the clothes in there. And I'm going to do his little other side. Come here, baby. And this blade is cold, so it's definitely not hurting at all. Good. So I'm going to put another, I think I'm going to put my fore guard on here. And I'm going to do under his neck. Let me see that. And on this, I like to take my finger and just put it underneath the loop, because it seems like I have better control of the animal. Especially when you're doing this part, so, you know, because you want them to hold their head up and stuff. So to me, it's just easier. Sometimes you can kind of like work through it. Sleepy time. Yeah, you are, little cat. Yeah, you are. Now, what are we going to do with this cute little face of yours, huh? Let me see. I don't really want to shave it down, but real short. So I'm just going to kind of work on this little face, see what I can do. Still trying to break the coffee this morning, because he came early this morning. I said, be here at 9. Well, she was here at 9, so that's good. I'm just going to take this fore guard, and I'm going to go down on his little face. Oh, and he don't like that. Oh, my goodness gracious alive. It's okay, Angel. It's okay, Babas. It's okay. Sometimes if they don't like that, I have tricked them and went up and, you know, did like I'm doing right now, just kind of just doing it without him even realizing what I'm doing, but seems like it works a little bit better like this.
I'll see.
Come see, baby.
Yeah, yeah.
Get on the foot side of you.
Yeah, we're gonna be okay. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna actually, okay, since he's giving me such a little fit, he don't really like it. I'm gonna take my scissors and I'm gonna trim a little bit, first of all. Move your little ear out the way. So I'm gonna cut your little ear. I'm just trimming his little face. We'll make sure that the ears are out of the way. Trimming it just a little bit. Mm-hmm. We also want to make sure they don't stick out their little tongue. And you see these eye boogers right here, people? Right here. These little eye boogers. To prevent this, all you really have to do is get a warm wash rag and wipe, or if you don't have a warm wash rag, get a baby wipe and just rub it and work it out. You can pull that with your fingernails, but some people might think that's gross, but it's your baby, you gotta take care of it, okay? I understand some people don't have time, I'm not knocking anybody, or but just, you know, to prevent that from happening, you can clean it. Or if you have like a little fine tooth comb, you can, you know, after you get it wet or while they're in the tub, you can take the little comb and comb it out. You can use any kind of a comb. You can even use your hair comb if you have one with little teeth in it. So, but anyway, so we want to try to get him spruced up and cute for mama. Okay, we're going to trim the bottom of this. See how much fun we're gonna have with you trying to do your little head, your little face. Okay, come see. Let's see if we can get this done. It's okay. And sometimes if you don't press it right up against the skin, which is looking out right now, don't understand why he is. I'm just gonna be doing this. I'm gonna have to probably take this off. Or sometimes if you just do it like this, it makes them feel like if they still have it on. And you can kind of, well, I just took it off. And I'm just holding his little head. I'm not holding the, I'm not squeezing it or anything. I'm holding the skull. You want to make sure that you hold the skull part on their head. You don't want to, you know, hurt them or hold their, the soft tissue. I'm just going to say it like that. Okay, we're going to do your little ears. And I hope you don't, let me do this. And I always groom the little ears. Okay, I don't that at all. So what's the deal, Lucille, huh? What's the deal, baby, huh? What's the deal? Come on, let me see. Let me get old, good boy. Just something about him, your face, he does not like. Now I can kind of see a little bit more of what I'm doing. Maybe I can kind of trick him a little bit. I'll see. I'm just going to do your little thing. That's all. Come on. Come on. Okay. A little bit here. Moving on. Okay. Okay. That's all right. Okay. I'm see. I mean, and then you can't give up too soon on trying to do something. See, I'm just barely skimming it. I'm not letting it touch his little skin. Maybe the vibration of the blade might be scaring him. So, I'm just going to do the best I can. Oh, look at that little, look at that cute little face. So, I'll just have to just use my scissors and be very careful. Let me see. I've got to get all this hair out of your teeth. See, I'm barely touching it. Okay, love, come see. And I'm holding the hair under his chin. Sometimes if you just take your scissors and just kind of, see, he don't mind me doing it between his little eyes. So you just kind of rub it and just kind of get the little snips in where you can. This ain't gonna be perfect like I wanted it to be, but I'm just cutting it off while I can, while he's letting it. Okay, but it's all right. It's all right. It's okay. Oh, you got that so sweet. Other side. I'm going to pull this hair up from, okay, it's all right. So you start out, you know, where you know he's not going to be, you know, freaking out, so to speak. You just kind of work your way down. So he's starting to relax now. He's not pulling his hand up. I mean, his head, he's not trying to get away from me, and I am barely holding the hair under his chin. And so he starts to relax. Now, I always pick up their lip, and you always pull the hair out from in their mouth. Okay, come see. And you just lift it right back in. We don't want you doing that. Okay? No. So I just kind of try to do that because that hair is not good for the teeth. Okay, it's all right. So yeah, I think I already put it on this side. Nope, there's a little piece of hair right there. Okay. No, and you want to be really careful doing this, not to snip the little tongue. I have snipped a couple little tongues, not off, but, you know, when they hurt, just try to stick it out real quick. Usually I try to hold their mouth shut, just put a little bit of pressure on it, but when she's being so good at this moment, I'm just doing what I can. Sometimes you just have to do whatever you can the way you can do it. Or whatever way they'll let you do it, huh, baby? Yes. Yes. And you're looking just so sweet. And I'm just going to cut this with the scissors so it ain't hurt anything. And I do believe he's going to let me go up on his neck right here. Go down on his neck. He's kind of like, okay, we're not doing anything. I'm not doing it. You just gotta take it gently sometimes. Okay. Sometimes you can just kind of sneak it in there. Okay. All right. You're just looking so cute, baby. And when you're trimming them, if you're cutting them, when you're trimming with scissors, if you're not sure of something, stop and assess it and go back. You're like, okay, I don't know about this. Or like, if I'm cutting and I'm like, and say his ear was here and I'm like, oop, nope, I don't want to cut his ear because if I do, I'm going to cut his ear. So stop and just look at it. Don't be in that much of a hurry. Because the last thing you want to do is hurt the sweet baby. And I'm going to go over this again around his, up by his little neck, so I can see where his head, where it stops and starts, the hair. He's such a cute little softball. Yeah. Yeah, see, he got so much better. Now I can tell. Okay, so we're just going to trim this hair. I really wish he would let me use the clippers because it would be so much cuter, but he won't. So we're just working with what we got. That's all we can do. Huh, baby. Huh. Yeah. Okay. Oh, you look just so precious. I'm going to cut this because this is a little knotty. Any tangles up in here. Best we can. Yeah, we are. Holding his hair under his chin. Just to keep it still from him just wanting to turn it and stuff. I don't think he would try to get away from me right now, but you never know, because you look so cute. You never know what they're doing. No, you never know, do you, huh? Oh, yes, you are. Okay, now. Woo! I got that hair off of you. Off your cute little face. Okay, now we are done with that for right now, and we're going to do your little ears. Okay, on the ears, people, look inside the little ear. If they got hair in their ears, which 9 times out of 10 they will, I pull the hair out of their ears. Some people shave it, some people don't do nothing with it, but I pull it out, and what I do is, you can buy regular ear powder, but what I did is actually I just put it in this bottle. This is just cornstarch. You can use cornstarch, you can use flour. It just something to absorb the moisture to where you can grip it to be able to pull it out. Now, a lot of times they don't like me doing this, but he is good. Which I've had several good ones, but But you just want to make sure that you get in there and get the hair out. I'd rather pull it and it just be gone. So people, like I say, some people cut it with scissors or whatever, but I don't do that. So we're just going to pull this hair out like so. I use my fingers lots of time. It's just easier. And then I'll take my little hemostat and just pull it out. Yeah. And voila, we're done with that. And now I'm gonna comb out your tail. We're gonna trim up your tail some, okay? I'm going to just leave his tail like this because it's really cute. I'm just going to trim it a little bit because I like it when they stand up and it flips over like that. Okay, that's all I'm going to do this day. Okay, I'm going to go give him a bath and I'll be back. Okay, this is Jax again. I have bathed him. I towel dried him. Now I'm going to dry him with the hair dryer. Or with my dryer.
Is I have bathed them first and then dry them and then groom them. But you do whatever works best for you. I do it both ways. Just depends on, you know, a lot of different things. But you definitely do not want to wash a dog that's matted. There's no way. So you would just have to
groom them, get the hair off, bathe them, and then do it again. So that's why the first time you don't have to be so perfect and try to get it all, you know, every hair. But if you're like me, you're going to try to. But he is so good. Oh, yeah, he looks so sweet. And we are, like, doing so great now. Oh, yeah, he looks so cute. I think your mama is going to be so happy with you today. I know she's going to be happy that I didn't have to shave you short. I know that for sure. And your grandma, Miss Missy. But anyway, I know life happens. If I said something in this video to offend anybody, I'm sorry, but I know life happens and we all get busy. We all just let things get away from us. And it, you know, and like me, you know, like right now it's my house. My house is upside down. I got stuff just laying everywhere. Because I've been so busy grooming. I'm fixing to make a bunch of stuff to put in the market at right here, Moss Bluff. It's going to be called Hidden Treasures. It's right where a little bit of this and that moved to the old bingo hall, which is right off of 171 on Telephone Road, right where they're building Brother Hare's that big church in the curve on the right. Well, a little bit of this and that is going to be right there on the left. It's a very nice building. Well, they actually finally redone it since the storms. So a lot of the people from Little Bit of This and That, they all moved on over. And then now, there's going to be another flea market there, which is good. So that's great. Because I know I was on the list a little bit of this and that, but it was 11 pages long. It would took me forever to get there. But anyway, who knows? I might get there one day. But anyway, if you're in Moss Bluff, go check out both of the flea markets. It'll be awesome. The more the merrier, I say. Have more people there, and you know, it's worth coming to Moss Bluff to go to two flea markets instead of one. So, in my opinion, I think so. And they'll have lots of good stuff at both of them. I'm gonna go and video the market in Moss Bluff once it gets up and going and booths get set up. I'm just gonna go and do a little video and show everybody what they got. I might go to the other market, video that one, show people what they got. Hey, why not help out one another? You know, it's not all about me. You know, the Lord's gonna bless. So if you keep it right with Him, He's gonna keep it right with you. That's how I feel. And don't get me started on anything else today. We'd be here all day. Oh, he's trying to get away from me. Oh, you are just so precious, baby. You look so good. I'm so excited. I did not have to shave you down. Oh, your mommy's going to be so happy. I can't wait for them to see you. And I am taking it down just a little bit more. I don't stop him, I have no hair. But anyway, I think it just looks better because it's hot and he don't come often. So this will last for a while, till probably after the holidays or close to it. But anyway. But if you want to bring it back sooner, that would be awesome too. So. But So anyway. Oh, this is our cute little puppy. Oh, you look so precious, darling. Oh, you're so cute. Let me comb your little head. Oh. See, clean hair. See how all these little hairs are coming up from everywhere. We got them everywhere, huh, baby? Oh, my gosh. You're just adorable. Yes, you are. You're precious. I wonder if he would let me do a... I'm going to attempt to do a guard over his head. It would be so much cuter if I could do a guard. Because it would just get it all really super even. Okay, come on. I'm going to try. Whoop. Oh, good. Oh, look. Oh, yay. Yay. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. That looks so... Okay. That's all. Whoop, that looks better. That was a lot easier than me trying to have to scissor the whole entire thing. We'll be looking like a Maltese, not like a poodle, but doing the best I can with what we got to work with. So I'm just going to leave his hair on his little face. I say I'm leaving. I keep cutting. I keep trimming. Trimming. But you want to get it mostly away from his ears. Because hair and stuff gets in those ears and gunk. And they get wet and damp and they stay moist and they get wet. Thank God his ears were not dirty or not bad. They're not. I didn't even wipe them out with nothing, so they weren't bad at all. Yeah, they weren't. No, they weren't. No, they sure was not. Or something on your foot, just don't freak out. It's going to grow back. In a few weeks, it's going to be right back. Yeah, it is, huh? It's going to be right back, and you are just so stinking cute. Okay. I'm just going to make sure when you trim your little ears that you go all the way to the leather. Which I'm not cutting his short, so I don't have to be as careful, I want to say. But I'm just trimming this a little bit. Yes, I am. To where it will look more uniform, I guess you would say. Okay. Oh, that looks so fresh. Now, let me see. Oh, that's so cute. Look at all these long hairs. Yeah, I usually come in here, and if there's long hairs underneath his ear, I either cut them or shave them. I do both. Just depends on what I'm doing at the time. Oh, you're going to look just so precious. Okay, now let me do your other side. It's always fun getting one side to match the other side. That's for sure. but he does have a little knot right there, a little tangle behind his ear, which is not uncommon. That happens all the time. My scissors, I got to sharpen these scissors. Look here. Oh, you're just so adorable and precious. This baby is just precious. Girl, you got a sweet baby. He is just precious. Don't let nobody tell you otherwise. He is adorable. Yeah, you're adorable. Yeah, I got a big old baby outside that's whining. I'm babysitting. Or dog sitting, whatever you want to call it. Okay, let me see. Okay. Oh, that is just my puppy dog laying down over there. His big old legs and paws and everything else that he's got going on over there. Woo! I got to go to the grocery store. I got to go try to survive. Chicken feed for my chickens. They are almost out. This is still not what I want. No, you're just adorable, baby. Oh, yeah, they got one there. Oh, that's a good stick. Oh, woo-hoo. Let me see underneath your chin real quick, make sure I got all this hair, because you didn't want me doing the doggone clipper, so use my scissors a little bit more. You still got crud in your mouth, and I scrubbed your face. Well, you didn't want me to do this. Your lip. I'm gonna have to clean that. Get me a wipe or a wash rag. Let me see. And his little tooth goes over that. That's fine. Okay. You look like a little puppy. That's what you look like to me. Oh, now you look so cute. Now, let me see your legs. Maybe I need to do your legs. Hold on, I'm not done yet. Nope, I gotta do your front legs. They look rough. Okay, let's see these front little legs here. Come here. Get a little more of this hair off of here. I'm seeing. Okay, come in. Come here, let's go side. Come here. Come here. No. Okay. What you're doing that for, because you've been so good the whole time. You've been freaking out me. Sometimes they just want to slip out for no reason at all. I know why they want to do that sometimes. Probably they're just tired. Ready to be done, huh? I don't blame you, baby. I'm ready to be done, too. stuff I need to do today.
Thank you.
I'm gonna put trimming on this baby because he's done. Brush it over here. You find it a brush. I see a little hair on my head that's hanging. Now, oh, you look adorable. Yes, you do. Oh, you look precious. He is a doll. Okay. All right, I'm going to put a bandana on him real quick.
And,
you know what
you're doing. Yeah, you're doing. Wait, come here. Love purple.
And I use the Pet Silk Rainforest scent cologne spray. Everybody loves it. And he's done. And this is Jax. Thanks. Bye.